Well, hey. So I've been working on this program for the past couple days. What it does is it goes through all the possible values that the melee random number generator can be. Quick background, the random number generator has about 4 billion possible different values. It's based off of a pretty simple formula that you can implement in a program. So that's what I did. And the way that melee figures out what character you're going to random is by advancing that random number in the generator. And so, even though there's about 4 billion different possible values, possible values that the random number generator can be, after about 10 or so random characters, you can determine where you are in that sequence of random numbers because of how many unique sequences of characters there are. And with that, knowing where you are in the random number sequence, you can predict how close random number generator events are. For example, pulling an item with Peach, which I'm about to demonstrate. So, to figure out where you are in the random number generator sequence, you have to provide it a list of characters that you roll random on the character select screen. So let's do that real quick. Now, after about 10 or so, that's enough to guarantee a unique sequence. To prevent, hitting duplicate sequences. Because there's going to be thousands and probably hundreds of thousands of, Dr. Mario, Mario, Luigi's. But once you start branching out and you give it enough characters in a row, it becomes the only sequence that's possible for this random number generator. Fapox. Bowser. And one more for good measure. And then you can just type in whatever and ask if you're done. Alright. Now after it finds the first hit of this sequence, it's going to return. And based off a configuration file you give it, it can search for different RNG-based events. And so I have a couple in here. Bomb, Beam Sword, and Stitch. I've recorded this video a couple times, actually, and every time I do the bomb one, it's a couple hundred iterations away, and I don't want to, sit through all that. So let's just do a Stitch base. Well, that's not too much closer. But luckily, this gives us the seed that we're currently on right here. Whoops. Oh, sorry about those beeps. PowerShell likes to beep at me when I backspace nothing. So we can just give it the seed. Let's see how close a bomb is. If a bomb's closer, then let's do that. Okay, yeah, perfect. 78. Okay, so you're going to have to bear with me while I count through this. Every time you roll a character on the CSS, it advances the RNG twice. And then if you type in hit the random button in the name sequence, in the tag menu, it rolls it once. So that's what you do if there's an odd number of iterations out. So here we go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34. 36, 38, 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58, 60, 62, 64, 66, 68, 70, 72, 74, 76, 78. Alright, let's hope I didn't miscount. Hey, there it is. Nice. So there's the bomb. I plan on using this to get guaranteed pulls and the Peach break the targets run. So it makes for easier world records runs. Oh, shoot. I tried to throw it at the wall, but I forgot no C-stick in one-player mode. But yeah. So that's just a demonstration. Cool stuff. Thanks for tuning in. Expect to see a world record from me or LDA soon, because I believe he said, Link's Dark Arrows, he said he would run this if it's practical. But I don't know. This is looking like thousands of iterations away to get certain pulls. But I'm going to try to figure out ways to blow through some iterations pretty quickly in controlled settings. I'll have to figure that out. But yeah, just a quick demonstration of cool stuff you can do with the random number generator in Melee. Peace out. And thanks for watching.